college basketball has always been big in the continental United States. In the state of Indiana, the sport is a way of life. Nestled between the banks of the Wabash and Ohio Rivers and Lake Michigan is Bloomington. It is here where the NCAA championship trophy rests. The architect is Bob Knight, who's won three national titles in 16 years with the Crimson Crimson. Knight's the brains, but without Keith Smart, the Hoosiers wouldn't have a third title under the general. Teaming with inside stars like Dean Garrett, Coach Knight has brought Indiana University the sweet spoils of victory. 170 miles north of Bloomington is Notre Dame, and that name alone is synonymous with tradition. The Irish fortunes have brightened since the arrival of the son of a caretaker named Digger Phelps. Though without a national title, Phelps and Notre Dame have spoiled the chances for others. Last year, it was number one North Carolina that became a part of that history. In 1981, top-ranked Virginia with Ralph Sampson saw their unblemished record tarnished by the Irish. To take the spoils in 88, Phelps will turn to his all-everything guard, David Rivers. It's been 10 years since Notre Dame made it to the Final Four. Rivers and his teammates have been the spoilers. Tonight in Bloomington, they're set for the spoils. ESPN presents NCAA basketball, Notre Dame versus Indiana. From a sold-out Assembly Hall in Bloomington, Indiana, it's the defending national champion Indiana Hoosiers against the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. Hello, everyone. I'm Tim Brando. Welcome to the month of December. The glut of college basketball is here, and we're happy to be bringing it to you tonight from the home of much of college basketball, the state of Indiana. This game is so important, and he enjoys working with me so much. Dick Vitale had to go from the land of the earthquake in Alaska just to be here with us for Indiana Notre Dame. Thanks a lot, Coach.
Well, Tim, I'll tell you right now, I didn't come all the way out here to be with you. I came out here to be in this environment where basketball is really big time. I wanted to see the General Robert Montgomery Knight and the sartorial splendor of Digger Phelps. I'd hitchhike to get here for this, Timmy.
They've got a very special talent in Rivers.
David Rivers is certainly one of the great guards in America. He's a Rolls Royce point guard, and he can even play second guard. He controls the tempo of the game. They're looking for him to score really big this year.
Just how special is David Rivers? Well, Bob Knight thought he was special enough to do this last year.
Hicks finding Stevenson. Well, he can shoot well. We'll watch for that early. Both he and Hicks are streaky shooting. Unbelievable. Right now, Indiana in a zone, which is usually a no-no by Bob Knight. I'm shocked. The 2-3 zone by Indiana. That is an absolute surprise.
You and I were there for that game, both you and I, and that is amazing that he would do that, but Rivers is a special talent.
Well, it certainly takes away the penetration of David Rivers, but that was really a real war of a game. It went down to the last minute. I think today the key in this basketball game will be the play of Gary Vos on the interior. He's going to have to neutralize the improving Dean Garrett, who's been astounding all in pre-workouts and also against Miami of Ohio in their opener.
So, Dean Garrett, obviously the key inside. Vos as well. Dick Vitale is here. The ground is shaking, even though the earthquake was way up in Alaska. A good one is on the way. We'll be back with the opening lineups in a moment. Right now, let's get back to John Saunders.
Okay, Tim and Dick, thank you very much. We'll go back to Assembly Hall in Indiana in just a moment. Notre Dame and Indiana. I want to tell you what we have coming your way at halftime. We'll have a look at those two teams as well as Purdue as we look at that outstanding program of basketball they have all over the state of Indiana. Of course, we will also update scores and have some highlights for you. So stay with us here on NCAA basketball coming your way from Assembly Hall in just a moment. Indiana and Notre Dame.
There's a free-spirited little animal whose territory is constantly expanding. It's the Ford Bronco 2. Making tracks in remote watering holes and lush feeding grounds. Clawing up mountain trails with V6 power to go where the herd gathers. And Bronco 2 switches to four-wheel drive when it's on the scent of off-road fun. The Ford Bronco 2. Its territorial range is bounded only by imagination.
Now get $500 cash bonus on all new Ford Bronco 2s.
Hey, that was a great answer. Where'd you learn about computers?
In the Army.
You were in the Army?
Yeah.
And now they're helping pay your way through college.
How come you know so much?
How do you think I got here?
Qualify for the GI Bill and the Army College Fund and earn $17,000 for college for only a two-year enlistment, or $25,200 for a four-year enlistment.
What you doing here?
Airborne.
You were airborne?
Find your future in the Army.
You used to jump out of airplanes?
You've never seen a shaver like this before. It's the new 3M Surgical Clipper by Remington. Hospitals are now using it, replacing blades to shave patients for surgery safely and comfortably. And you can benefit from this advanced technology by using the Remington Microscreen Rechargeable. It shaves as close as a blade or your money back. And the Lady Remington Rechargeable also shaves without a cord. Now, lowest price ever on Remington Microscreen Rechargeable.
Okay, listen up. Oakley here is filling in for Ball tonight.
For 3 years, Bill Oakley took orders. But tonight, he's got to stand up and take charge.
You make America work.
Here's to you, the clean, crisp taste of Beechwood-aged Budweiser. For all the guys who know it's not what you say, but what you do.
Welcome back to Bloomington. Tim Brando along with Dick Vitale, the number five Hoosiers of Indiana against Notre Dame. We're ready now for the starting lineups. Here with them, public address announcer Chuck Pratt.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Indiana University welcomes you to the Assembly Hall. Here are your starting lineups for tonight's game. For the Fighting Irish from the University of Notre Dame, at one forward, a 6'6 junior from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, number 24, Mark Stevenson. The other forward, a 6'9 sophomore from Plantation, Florida, number 43, Scott Paddock. The center, a 6'9 senior from the Queens, New York, number 54, Gary Bose. One guard, a 6-foot senior from Jersey City, New Jersey, number 4, David Rivers. The other guard, a 6'2 sophomore from Peoria, Illinois, number 40, Jameer Jackson. The head coach for the Fighting Irish, on his 17th season at Notre Dame, Richard Digger Phelps. And now for the Hoosiers of Indiana, at one forward, a 6'9 senior from Salina, Kansas, number 11, Todd Jadlow. At the other forward, a 6'6 junior from Cincinnati, Ohio, number 20, Rick Calloway. In the middle, he's a 6'10 senior from San Clemente, California, number 22, Keith Dillon. At one guard, a 6'1 senior from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, number 23, Pete Smart. At the other guard, a 6'6 senior from Hamilton, Ohio, number 32, Steve Alford. The head coach for the Hoosiers, now in his 17th season in Bloomington, Bob Knight.
In their 17 years, Knight and Phelps have met many times, but Notre Dame has only won four of those times. Back with a tip in a moment.
Trophy whitetail deer hunters are a dedicated lot, but the bow hunter is a very special breed. Hi, I'm Kurt Gowdy, and now for just $49.95, you can experience bow hunting in its purest form in our new videotape, The Bow Hunter. No greater challenge is presented to a bow hunter than bagging that elusive whitetail trophy. Now you can live it almost firsthand and revel in the victory of the prize. Whether your approach is high-tech or basic and simple, you'll thrill at the hunts in this video. It's the next best thing to being out in the woods yourself. I know you'll want to order yours today.
Use MasterCard or Visa and call 1-800-554-9000. That's 1-800-554-9000. Or send a check or money order to The Bow Hunter, P.O. Box 121, Plainville, Connecticut, 06062. Order The Bow Hunter today.
Women's NCAA Basketball, Notre Dame versus Indiana, is brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? And by the U.S. Army. Learn how to get an edge on life. Be all you can be. And by Remington. The Remington Micro Screen Ultimate Shaver with exclusive beard lifter.
In Bloomington, Indiana, Dick Vitale. Let's start, as always, with your keys to victory.
Well, when you look at the keys right now, they're going to have to find a way to stop the passing game of Indiana. They get such great shot selection out of their passing game. But Digger's team last year only allowed 59 points a game. And they must control the boards. Last year, Notre Dame was one of the premier rebounding teams in America. They had a plus-six margin on the opposition. That must continue here today. For Indiana, they must dominate inside, and that starts with Dean Garrett, who's going to need a lot of help from Todd Jadlow and also Ricky Callaway. But Garrett has the ability to dominate. And, of course, they must contain David Rivers. If he's allowed to penetrate, get in the open court, you can see Notre Dame having a big, big night.
We have a Big Ten crew. Joel Sylvester, Jim Bain, and Tim Higgins are the officials. Jim Burr was scheduled and was scratched from the officials' crew, and it was Burr that was involved in the controversy against the Soviets. And we'll comment on that a bit later. The tap is controlled by Notre Dame, and David Rivers will give it to Jameer Jackson, who'll run the show for Digger Phelps.
Already Isle is bodying up on David Rivers. Going to play him very physical, number 32. Man-to-man defense, a lot of help in the lane. Yes, Bobby Knighted. Isle can stop Rivers. He said, we'll find out tonight.
Stevenson under pressure throws up the air ball. Garrett brings it down. Keith Smart.
What an athlete, Smart. Great vertical jumping ability, quickness, and gained a great deal of confidence as the year progressed.
Isle. Jadlow loses it, picked up by Isle. 2-0 Hoosiers.
Isle's got a good touch, Timmy. He's got good rotation on his shot. He's an excellent role player. He's a player that does so many things and can play three positions on a floor. He's guarding number four, David Rivers.
He held Newsom, the star guard from Miami of Ohio, to 2-for-8 from the floor in one half. But David Rivers is a different item, and he buries it from three-point range, and it's 3-2 Fighting Irish.
Newsom and Rivers, you're talking a whole different ball game. Rivers certainly a multi-dimensional. Great pass.
Jadlow, a charge is the call.
Jim Bain with the call gets the offensive foul, but an excellent pass to break up the half-court trap of Digger Phelps. There's the diagonal pass. Here goes the offensive move. Oh, yes, that defensive player is entitled to that plane. He can go up. That's like the principle of verticality. The defensive player is entitled to the plane on that floor once he establishes position.
No argument from Coach Knight, but he told the state legislature in Indiana today that there would be no more arguments from his sidelines. The fans would have to come through for the fans of the Hoosiers and home tilt.
Do you really believe that? I got a better chance of growing here than that happening.
He addressed the legislature earlier today in Indianapolis. Stevenson stripped by Smart, recovered by Jameer Jackson. Finally cleared by Isle.
If Isle stands up, that's a walk-in violation, but makes the pass from the floor, that's a good play.
Remember now, Joe Hillman is injured with a lower back problem. There again, right on cue is the man that's in the lineup for him. And we're talking about Jadlow.
Todd Jadlow, they're looking for him to give them some real scoring on the inside. They think they're really going to miss Daryl Thomas. That's what Bobby Knight was telling us before the game, that people don't realize how important Thomas was down on the boxes.
Post down low on the blocks, rejected by Garrett.
It's Rejection City by Dean Garrett. Uh-oh.
He's smart.
Timeout, Digger. Timeout, Digger.
Two and a half minutes are gone, and the fans of Indiana on their feet already.
The combination of the JUCO players, Garrett and Smart.
Rivers off the iron. Garrett and Jadlow were vying for it. Credit the rebound to Big Dean.
We've seen multi-defenses by Notre Dame. We've seen a half-court trap. We've seen a man-to-man. And we've seen the zone. They're zoning right now. 1-2-2. Digger Phelps, an outstanding bench coach. They're going to make Indiana shoot that perimeter shot.
Nice alley-oop inside for Garrett. And he's fouled by Paddock.
And words are exchanged between Paddock and Garrett.
Paddock's a physical player, came out of Plantation, Florida, came over to Notre Dame. Norman Sloan now getting all those great players to stay home as we look at Digger. Remember my all GQ coaching five? I mean, he can dress with the best of them.
The first team foul.
I thought he did a great job last year. I thought that team overachieved. They pulled some real surprises. Played North Carolina tough in the regionals before they were beaten.
Smart operating the Indiana offense. Interestingly, we were talking with Coach Knight prior to the game. He said, well, you think you can play the point? And he said, tell me what the point guard really is.
Yeah, he doesn't like that terminology. He says, us guys in TV make up all those terms, point guards.
Post with a steal. He got his hand in there. And there's Isle. Chadler.
Oh, what a look. Oh, baby. Slam jam, bam. Dean Garrett. Uh-oh, they're rocking and rolling in Bloomington, Indiana.
I'd say Jadlow was ready to play, wouldn't you?
And I'm ready to be here with you.
It's a five-point lead for the Hoosiers. Six unanswered points since Rivers hit the three-pointer moments ago. 3.5 minutes gone in the first half. And there again is the perimeter shot from Rivers. That one counts for the deuce. It's 8-5.
That's where you need an All-American player. He silenced the crowd. He made the big play. David Rivers going to have a banner year this season. So they're sitting in that zone. They're going to give you that wing jump shot. That's the one area Indiana's going to have to prove they can make it.
Keith Smart for three. And it's 11-5. The Hoosiers with the lead.
I asked Bobby also, what does he anticipate or expect in terms of scoring power out of the backcourt without Alford? He said, heck, he said, Smart's got to become a big, big scorer for us.
Rivers negotiates, turned it over. He palmed the ball.
See, it's very difficult to drive against Indiana because they get help defense better than most people, Timmy.
The Hoosiers are 4-for-4 from the floor, and they lead 11-5.
Winning the world over.
Now, during Ford's Leadership Celebration, get a cash bonus of up to $600 on the cars that are winning the world over. Combine your cash bonus with an option package discount and save over $1,600 on Thunderbird, $1,200 on America's design leader, Taurus, and over $1,100 on the world's best-selling car, Escort.
Winning the world over. Have you driven a Ford lately?
A special report from the trading floor at Payne Weber. While you're coping with the changes in the marketplace, there's something else that you can be doing now.
Investors should be looking at their tax situation. It's not too early to start planning tax strategies for the balance of 87, because this year is going to be particularly complex. Tax reform has ended the preferential treatment of capital gains, and there are other changes as well. The extreme volatility of both the stock and the bond market recently, following 5 years of a bull market, gives many investors opportunities to minimize their tax liabilities. So talk to your tax advisor and your investment executive about tax planning and upgrading the quality of your portfolio. And read our new report, Year-End Tax Strategies. It could help you do better at tax time. You can get a copy through any Payne Weber office.
Thank you. And goodbye for now from Payne Weber.
The Hoosiers have not missed from the floor, but they've had high percentage shots,
well,
haven't they?
Here's an excellent two-man play. He drives the ball right at the defender, and then he dumps it off to Garrett for the easy slam dunk. Look at the intensity right here. Freeze it. See how he brings the defensive player to him? He brings the defensive player to him, Jadlow did, and now he has the quick passing lane inside to Garrett for the slam dunk. What you want to do in that situation, you want to stay a little wider than the lane when you're two against one in transition.
From the floor, Indiana perfect, and Notre Dame 2-for-5, and of course all of that has been David Rivers.
You know, you mentioned Jim Burr before. I want to point this out. Burr was assigned this game, and there's been a heated battle between Bobby Knight and Burr. It started the LSU game in that NCAA tournament. He had the game, didn't call technical there. He should have in that game, and he slammed the phone down. He had the Soviet Union game, but I thought Burr acted intelligently. He asked to be taken off this game, so any rumors that he was removed, forget it. My reports tell me Jim Burr said, I didn't want to take anything away from Indiana Notre Dame game, and I'd rather not work the game because let the game be the spotlight. I thought it's an intelligent move.
He really acted in the best interest of the game. Dean Garrett. And it's 13-5, and the Hoosiers have an half dozen from the floor.
Garrett, who came out of junior college, played on a Pan-American team, did not play well there. Played it well during the tryouts, but didn't play well for Denny Crum during the actual game.
Post answers, and it's 13-7.
John Shumate did a great job with Gary Vos. He was a different player in the middle of the year and the end of the year than in the beginning. In fact, last year in the first meeting between Notre Dame and Indiana, he did not score a point. There's a 2-3 matchup. They're playing the matchup. I think today in modern day basketball, the way kids are limited shooting the jump shot, it's really intelligent going to this.
Smart missed it all that time. Knocked out of there by Paddock, and Jameer Jackson running the show. They didn't figure that he could run the point for this club, but he's really worked on his ball handling skills in the last season.
Well, all they wanted to do is bring the ball up the floor and then put it in the hands of David Rivers. Great look by Rivers.
Boy, was it ever, and Jameer on the receiving end, making it 13-9.
He's part of the Louisiana connection. John Thompson does well recruiting in Louisiana, but so does Digger Phelps. Orlando Woolridge was a former player from that area, and now he has Tim Singleton on the bench as well.
Safe to say that if Dale Brown doesn't get them, Digger or John Thompson will in that state. Jadlow is open.
I'm impressed with Jadlow, Tim. He's showing versatility. He showed he can make the play on the inside, and now he shows he can shoot the perimeter jump shot.
15-9. This game beginning much as did last year's game from a scoring standpoint, although we haven't seen a zone from Knight, and there's a travel. Second turnover committed by Rivers.
Well, he got a little bit in a hurried position there, and he lifted his pivot foot prior to putting the full ball on the floor.
Last year, the Hoosiers got the early lead. Indiana out to an 8-point lead, and then you see there the turnover story. Indiana's defense turning on its offense.
David is much quicker this year than he was last year. Certainly a courageous player after what he went through last season after that auto accident. There's that matchup.
Alloway off the screen from Jadlow.
See, the game is becoming perimeter oriented, and that's exactly what Digger Phelps wants.
Stevenson got Callaway airborne. He's a great athlete.
He has good head fake right there by Stevenson.
And a foul against the Irish. Indiana will get it the other way.
Jim Bain had a call underneath. I missed the call, Timmy.
Was away from the ball.
You're going to watch Stevenson now hit the little jump shot. And he's got a foul here. Look at those guys battling inside. He's got 11 on the call. Jadlow getting physical inside.
So now the Irish with a good trip down the floor. And a foul against Post, pushing off against Dean Garrett, so they missed an opportunity there.
Jody Sylvester with the call. We got an excellent crew right now. Jim Bain, certainly one of my all zebras on my top five in officiating. Jody Sylvester and Tim Higgins do a solid job.
Gone from the Indiana team, of course, Sir Alford. Of course, Thomas down low, who meant a great deal to this club, perhaps more than a lot of people fail to realize.
Well, and missing Joe Hillman also, who's out with a ruptured disc in his back. They anticipate he might be back Saturday.
Paddock picking up another foul, and then you look at the Irish. They lose the inside scoring of Donald Royal. They only have a couple of double-digit scorers returning to their starting lineup.
I think we're going to see shortly on the floor Keith Robinson and Tim Singleton. Both are heralded players. Robinson was a victim of Proposition 48. He's a long-range, explosive scorer. Digger did not want to start them in this environment and put him in this pressure cooker initially as new players.
Always screening. Indiana Hoosiers.
They really lay screens on the inside.
Callaway's shot, the iron unkind. Bose losing it to Jadlow. His arms are waving. And now Rivers in the open floor where he's so very special.
But Indiana gets back defensively, Tim, in transition.
And Paddock is rejected and fouled by Jadlow. 11:53 remaining in the first half, and the Hoosiers leading by four. Jadlow with his second foul. This one. Check that, his third personal foul, and that means Cree Smith will be brought into the lineup. Jadlow, though, very active in the first few moments of this game, and the crowd appreciating it.
Well, Bobby Knight appreciates it, and he's the most important person in the crowd. He went over and said, nice job, Todd. He'd rather see him be physical and play aggressive basketball. You know, I mentioned defensive transition. I saw a clinic by Lute Olson's Arizona team getting back defensively against two of the better running teams in America, also Syracuse and Michigan. And it's so important in modern day basketball to really eliminate the three-on-ones and the two-on-ones.
Now, the earthquake was not the only surprise in Alaska. Lute Olson's Arizona Wildcats. I don't know that anyone can beat that Arizona team in the Pac-10. There you see their shooting, and it's outstanding from the line.
Well, both these clubs shot outstanding basketball on the free throw line. It's certainly a deficient area for Syracuse, and the reason today that they're back at Syracuse 2-2 instead of 4-0.
It's 15-12, the Hoosiers with the lead. The Irish behind Rivers and Digger Phelps still in this game.
What can you give to all your dear friends? Give them the gift that adds a little color to their lives. Every day, USA Today. In four concise, colorful sections, USA Today brings your friends up to date on the latest news from every state across the USA. Quick tips and important info for the money-minded. All the latest sports stats. In life, you'll find the hottest trends. And for us cross-country travelers, it sure helps to know the weather out there. So call now and receive 13 weeks of USA Today for only, $29.25. That's a savings of 10% off the regular price. Plus, if you order a USA Today gift subscription now, you'll get a special holiday ornament and a $5 AT&T long-distance gift certificate free. Call now and give the gift that'll make them shout out with glee. USA Today.
You'll go down in history.
Bad to the bone. I broke a thousand hearts before I met you. I'll break a thousand more, baby.
Bob Knight could be bad, but he won't throw the chair again. Look what they've installed this year. Brand new, some padlocks to make certain that the chair will not be thrown. You know, but as bad as he may be, there is a good side, isn't there?
Well, you look at numbers that he's posted here at Indiana. I think the sad commentary about the whole situation is, number one, I'm hoping that we don't see him go out a la Woody Hayes and be remembered for all those incidents. I'd rather see him be remembered for what we're looking here. The numbers are so impressive, and I believe he's a lock for the Hall of Fame induction. He's been nominated this year, and I think he'll get in. Certainly, it was a no-no leaving the court. He said, Dick, I did not take my team off the court. The officials signed the book, meant the game was forfeited, but he acted in an irresponsible manner because, realistically, him getting three technicals and not leaving the place, he was responsible for his team.
Bree Smith starts with a bang, and it's 17-12. The Hoosier lead back to five, and they are torrid from the floor.
Smith was 7-for-7 from three-point range last year, was 7-for-8 for the season.
Rivers.
Oh, David Rivers shooting the long-range jump shot. We know he can drive, but Indiana has negated his one-on-one ability in the open court. You haven't seen any fast break opportunities, have you, Tim?
8 of the 15 points scored for the Irish by David Rivers. Get used to that statistic as Keith Smart throws it away and will not make Knight a happy man.
I definitely feel a great decision by Digger Phelps to play against an Indiana to start the season and then a Louisville on Saturday over at the Hoosier Dome. That'll get these kids ready for the rest of the year, and they're going to have a big year again, Notre Dame, this season.
Rivers for three.
He's got the touch. He's got the range. He is really excited about the year because he said his quickness has come back.
What happened to the three Ds when he would drive, draw, and deliver, as you'd say? Well, he's been all perimeter to this point.
Well, it's tough to drive against Indiana because they close off the driving angles. They get great help defensively.
It's a one-point lead for the Irish, their first. This with Indiana shooting at an unbelievable percentage from the floor.
See, that's where you want to go. You want to go into the gut of the defense and utilize maybe Garrett as a passer.
This game has the earmarks of a great one this early in the year when you consider how well the Hoosiers are playing and Notre Dame still with the lead.
A lot of strategy going on the floor by both coaches. They've decided to play the physical players against Rivers, Smith, and also
aisle.
Keith Smart. Give Stevenson credit for staying with him. Smith is open for three.
They can spot up and shoot the three-point shot. Certainly carried them last year with Steve Alford. They led the nation in percentage from three-point range. Take a look right now at the help defense. Watch the guys away from the ball. They'll always be in help position in the lane. Look at Garrett right now.
David, once again.
He's on fire, a la Austin Carr when he starred for the Notre Dame Fighting Irish.
21 to 20, Notre Dame with a one-point lead. Under 10 minutes remaining in the first half.
Both clubs playing a half-court game, too. They must have good execution because both clubs play solid team defense.
Rivers is 4-for-5 from three-point range. Smart off the back iron. Paddock with the rebound.
Good rebounding position by Paddock. He had 7 rebounds in the game last year as a freshman.
Now Rivers bringing the ball up the floor.
Most gives his body up for the screen.
Most keeping it alive, losing it to Cree Smith.
Uh-oh.
End-to-end, and Keith Smart lost the opportunity. Lost the handle. There's Garrett.
Oh, what a pass by one Juco to another Juco. And the two Jucos had the red and white screaming with joy last year as they won their third national championship under the General Robert Montgomery Knight.
22-21, Indiana by one. And now it's Smith on Rivers. Doubled. And Stevenson drives. And it's lost out of bounds by Paddock.
They forced the ball right there. Here comes Robinson. I can't wait to see him. Heard so much about him when he came out of high school. Digger told me tonight he's anticipating a great career from Robinson. He averaged about 30-some a game in high school and about 18 rebounds a game out of Buffalo, New York.
New York's Mr. Basketball Award winner in 86. A sophomore, of course, sat out last year with Proposition 48's ruling. And joining him out there, Sean Connor, who was an outside shooting gem for the Irish.
He had a chance to win the game last year. They were down 2. He had a 3-point opportunity and came up empty.
Kyle picked up his foot, took the shuffle step. Jimmy Higgins right on target to make the call.
So many players do that. They lift the pivot foot prior to taking the ball and putting it to the deck and getting it out of their hands. Again, look from up on top. Watch the help away from the ball. See the people in the zone, almost like zoning. They play man-to-man on the ball.
Off the back iron. Touched by 3 before Rivers finally came away with it.
Digger gives him the free license to do what he wants with the ball.
Connor with an air ball, but Jameer Jackson is there.
Jackson, a good athlete. Not really what you would call a skilled ball handler or a great shooter, but a good athlete. They like to set the little high post screen for Rivers to come off.
Jackson. Barry Vos in traffic. He and Smart fighting for it. Finally, the foul against Keith, and that will get Bob Knight's attention.
Gary Vos was trying to freeze the defender with some pump fakes inside.
It happened right in front of Knight. Jim Bain made the call.
Well, we watch Vos right now aggressively go after the loose ball. There he is, 54. He stays on the ground. He wants to take it up. It looked like he had a ball. Oh, no. Let's see. Watch right here. He's slapping the ball. He finally gets him for going across the wrist. I don't know. So close to call, but Jim Bain right on the action. Gary, I'll tell you right now, you look at Vos. This big horse came out of Collentine High School in New York, where they might have, Tim, the best high school team in America. They beat Archbishop Malloy with Rodan and Kenny Anderson in their opening game. Anderson heralded by many as the best point guard in the nation, and Rodan will be going to play for Louis Carnesecca at St. John's.
Most grew up in Jamaica. Soccer and cricket were his first loves.
John Shoemake's done a great job working with him. Also, Shoemake's done a tremendous job recruiting as Notre Dame has signed 3 blue chippers, LaFonso Ellis, a kid by the name of Keith Tower with a world of potential at 6'11", and Elmer Bennett, who will play immediately from out of Texas.
And finally, we're tied, and now an Indiana turnover. That's their 5th.
Oh, what a nice pass. The excellent bounce pass.
Connor makes it count, and it's 24-22. The Fighting Irish under 7 minutes left in the first half.
David Rivers, fundamentally solid, gives the good bounce pass on a 45-degree angle cut by Connor.
I think the decision of playing this matchup zone is excellent by Digger Phelps.
Smith is open off the screen from Isle. Connor gets the rebound. And you notice Garrett was really blocked off well by Vogt.
Well, I was just going to mention, Tim, the one thing about the matchup, you have a good triangle for rebounding position. The people are in great rebounding position.
Vogt off the Aaron Robinson follow.
His first shot as a collegian, Keith Robinson. They're going to love him at the Joyce Athletic Convocation Center.
And he's also got an outstanding outside shot. He's not just an inside power player.
That was beautiful that they changed the name of the Convocation Center. Gave it a name of the Reverend Edward Joyce, who's been such a great leader administratively for Notre Dame.
Isle.
I gotta like Isle. He can play defense. He's the kind of player you want in your club. He does all the intangibles.
Inside, outside kind of guy. You can play him almost anywhere on the floor.
Hey, don't steal my lines now. I use that terminology, inside, outside.
I've worked with you too long. Knocked away and the foul on Robinson. Up the back of Callaway.
That's the one major concern about new kids who haven't played. Playing defense, playing aggressively, trying to get to the boards, getting in foul trouble. I saw it with Terry Mills with Michigan. You can see it with Robinson in a minute here. That's a major concern for coaches.
It's 26-24, Notre Dame with 5.5 left.
Gonna dance your whole life away? What about your future? Don't you worry about getting old?
He doesn't have to. He has a MetLife retirement plan. MetLife annuities earn tax-deferred interest and guarantee an income for life. What do you say to that?
Away?
Oh, brother. Get Met. It pays.
See this long row of junkers? It's not too tough a road for the famous Ford Bigfoot, but can a regular Ford 4x4 drive over it carrying a Chevy? Watch as the Ford starts to claw over the twisted metal. Only Ford has twin traction beam front suspension, and this year only Ford has a complete line of multi-port fuel-injected engines. Yes, the Ford makes it over the torture road and joins its big brother. Ford, the best-selling pickup in the world.
Now get $500 cash bonus on all new F-Series pickups with manual transmission.
The network for college basketball brings you the Temple Owls. Coach Cheney against Coach Hazard. UCLA, the Bruins, the defending Pac-10 champions, 10 o'clock Eastern time, right here on ESPN.
That's a game Walt Hazard and UCLA must win as we look at all the banners flying high here in Indiana country. Certainly they have loads of banners at Pauley Pavilion, but the Pac-10, I'll tell you one thing, Lute Olson is certainly doing his part, but if they want to get national respect, Temple must be beaten at home by UCLA, and Temple's got an outstanding team. Look for a great frosh, shaking bacon, Mr. Macon.
You remember last year, Hazard was coming off that early season victory against North Carolina, highly ranked at that time, and the Owls pretty much took care of his club in Philadelphia.
Well, I was in Philadelphia, down at Pauley Pavilion. UCLA is much tougher, and they got a great guard, and Pooh Richardson, certainly in the open court. He's one of the most creative guards in America. Here comes a little half-court matchup. See, Digger's an outstanding bench coach. Just to take him out of a rhythm, he changes the look. They'll go back in there, key three.
Callaway feeds Isle baseline. And it's jammed home by Garrett.
Hey, Garrett has really become such an active player, a dominating player. He developed last year and is getting better and better with every minute on the floor.
Coach Knight has seen his team play well, but Rivers perhaps better. And the Fighting Irish are tied with 5 minutes left. Good pass to Paddock, rejected by Garrett.
Garrett's doing it all on the defensive end, the offensive end. Nice, simple screen and roll executed by Rivers and Paddock.
Garrett picks up the foul simply by great hustle down there.
Here comes the little screen and roll. There's the screen now by Paddock. They switch. He has inside position. But Mr. Garrett says, thou shalt not enter thy lane. That's the first commandment of Indiana basketball.
Look at those block shots for Garrett. You think that mattered in winning the NCAA championship?
Almost had a 5-second violation. They did. Remember, in college basketball, the ball must touch a player on the floor by the count of five. In the NBA, it simply has to leave the hand of the player throwing the ball inbounds before the count of five. Hoosiers looking for the lead. There's that matchup. Play a man in the area of the floor. Arizona did a great job with that against Syracuse and also against Michigan.
Callaway is open. Ricky hasn't found his touch tonight thus far.
Oh, what a pass. What a pass.
Haddock missed the dunk.
David Rivers doing it all.
David's shot too shallow and out of bounds was Robinson.
He rushed that shot. He really rushed that shot, number one, and it was a little bit out of his range.
And Robinson picked up the foul, pushing off while on the line.
Here comes Singleton on the floor, number 10, giving David Rivers a little rest. Singleton's got ultra quickness. Digger smiled when I asked him, will Singleton be able to help you this year? He said, Dick, you get a look at him tonight and you let me know Saturday down at the Hoosier Dome.
Singleton on Smart, number 10 in blue, out of Carver High School in New Orleans. All-state selection there, perennial all-state selection.
There's that matchup again.
Smart. He too is having problems from the outside. Garrett keeping it alive for the man that isn't.
What a play by Garrett. Garrett not only keeps the ball alive, he has the awareness where to find the open man. And he gets it to the open man for the three-point shot. Dean Garrett has become a genuine star.
And Bree Smith, 3-for-4 from the floor since checking in for Jadlow, who is saddled in foul difficulty with three early. Robinson for three. We told you he had range. Callaway brings it out for Indiana.
Ricky's really been quiet. He's been a quiet player on the floor.
There he is.
Ricky Callaway has finally arrived here in Bloomington, Indiana, number 20. He was the freshman of the year in the Big Ten 2 years ago. Had an outstanding rookie year. Last year, he was troubled by lots of injuries, knee and then a wrist injury.
Five unanswered points now for the Hoosiers.
There's that help defense. They really played out as well as any team in the nation. Constantly closing the lane. You may beat one guy, but you're going to get someone stepping your path.
Jackson is fouled, and you notice with the score tied, Phelps went to Singleton and some of the support role players, and now suddenly with Indiana scoring five unanswered, he'll bring Stevenson and Bose, and yes, David Rivers back into the lineup to spell Paddock and Robinson, and the youngster in the backcourt, Singleton, will remain in the game. It's a big game intrastate-wise, but obviously, Jameer Jackson is the man for whom Rivers will come in for. He's at the free throw line, so David is, as of yet, not checked in. But the point there being, as big as this game is, it is still early in the season. You want, if you're Digger Phelps, to give Singleton an opportunity, but at the same time, you don't want to give up too many unanswered points to the Hoosiers at home at Assembly Hall.
Jackson came out of Manual High School out of Peoria, Illinois, where they have a great player in Peoria by the name of David Booth, who'll be playing for Joey Meyer next season, heavily recruited, about 6'7".
The Fighting Irish trail 31-28 at Assembly Hall.
It's been a long day, big boy. Still got something left?
Sure you do.
Introducing the G-Shock 5200 watch from Casio. The sports watch that's ready for action with a built-in shock absorber. It's tough, so tough, this G-Shock can take a slap in the face. And not even flinch. The G-Shock 5200, just one of Casio's water-resistant sports watches. It's one tough watch to beat.
Do you know why Spuds McKenzie has so much fun at parties?
Because he's always in control.
Spuds knows it's cool to live by one simple rule.
Know when to say when.
A reminder from Anheuser-Busch.
Coming up at halftime, John Saunders, our studio host, will have a feature on the Hoosier State. plus scores from the top 20, and we'll install our first installment of the Windex Player of the Week, which will be a staple throughout the course of the year of college basketball on ESPN.
We take a look here at a little jumper, and I watch Dean Garrett, very active inside, great timing, explosive offensive rebounder, and he's all excited. Look at him pumping. He says, I know I've arrived here. This is my team now. I'm the star. Steve Alford is down in Dallas.
With Rivers out of the lineup, Dick, the Hoosiers went 9-2 in the last 3 minutes and 45 seconds, so Phelps quickly gets him back into the lineup.
Well, he's the heart and guts of Notre Dame, no doubt about it. As Digger has stated in all their press guys, he's going to be the guy that has to carry them and supply the offensive punch as you look at Richard Phelps.
Smart at the line, he had an opportunity to collect the field goal there.
The one great thing about both institutions playing here, you got people that graduate at the conclusion as you look at the MVP of the NCAA tournament, the shot that silenced all the Syracuse people at the end of the game. These people graduate, and I guess that's what college athletics is all about, Tim, in the eyes of everyone. And that's why these institutions are so proud. Not only do they win basketball games, but their people walk down the aisle and get that diploma.
7 points now for Keith Smart.
See, there's the pressure on the basketball. There's really four parts of Indiana's defense. They want to deny the ball on a wing. They want to pressure the ball. They want to beat cutters to the ball. And they want to finalize by blocking out.
And they did there, and Keith Smart brings it down.
Those are the four parts of Indiana team defense.
He's loose.
Oh, not a good play right there.
There he is, hustling again, drawing the foul inside.
He did make an aggressive hustling play after losing control on the finger roll down the lane.
When Bob Knight first had the youngster, the junior college star Keith Smart, he said, I've got to teach him to play under control. In junior college, you don't play my way. And that's the reason why he shied away from junior college talent during his tenure until last year.
Well, he wanted to get quickness, Tim. He really wanted to bring some quickness in the program and some explosiveness. They were really lacking that quickness to really challenge on a national level like they did in the past. And he thought that Smart and Garrett would provide it. He was 100% right, because they did.
Remember with Garrett, he was telling us he had to work on his feet. He had to develop quicker feet. Didn't take long for those feet to take him to the NCAA championship along with Keith Smart.
It's been documented on Keith Smart, 5'3" his senior year in high school. Then he grew to about 5'7" at the end of the year. Really was a non-player, went to Southern University, told he couldn't play, then went out to junior college at Garden City under Jim Carrey and became a great player. And George Ackles, a former teammate, as he steps out, 6'11", will be joining Jerry Tarkanian at Vegas. There's a three-pointer.
And that ends a two-minute drought for the Irish. 34-31, Indiana by three, just under 2 minutes remaining in the first half.
Connor might be their best long-range shooter. He demonstrated there why Digger has great confidence in his range as a shooter.
Callaway just won't fall for Ricky early. Bose with the rebound.
There it is, pressure again on the basketball, denying on the wings, helping out in the lane, beating cutters to the ball, getting over the top. Now he goes third man, over the top is second man, sliding through his third man defensively.
Robinson with the turnaround.
He's going to be a good one. There's something about his game you just like watching the way he runs up and down the floor, Tim. He has the look of a player. He has that thoroughbred style, and you know he's going to really excite him over at Convocation Center.
He's already 2-for-2 as a collegian since entering this game.
Some guys are just made. They have the mentality to score. I believe he has.
Garrett's shot won't fall. Smart is on the rim, and he also collected the foul, cutting through. Joey Sylvester there to make the call, and that's the second on Keith Smart. Now Jim Bain and Timmy Higgins will negotiate this.
There's the entry. This little turnaround jump shot. Now Smart's going to come flying down the lane. Reckless. No doubt about it. Bill Mallory certainly could use him with that kind of quickness. Mallory did a great job in football here at Indiana.
They wave the foul off. Basket interference against Smart.
They had basket interference prior to the foul.
Right.
You knew he was in the cylinder with that 40-inch vertical jump. He's going to get inside the cylinder most times.
Notice Notre Dame setting the high screen. You must get over the top of that screen right now. Well, they switch. See, Indiana's just simply switching on the screen.
Well, you see Kyle on Robinson rather than Rivers. The multifaceted talents defensively of Steve Isle, and now Indiana looking for the three-point lead. 35 seconds left. The clock is off. The shot clock is off so they can hold it. Smith inside to Isle. It's passed post for the easy dukes.
Well, an excellent power move by Isle. But great ball movement. They throw the diagonal pass right over the top of the zone. They skip pass. Here comes that. They're going to just switch on that little high screen. David said, I don't need the screen. I'm going the other way.
Isle knocking it away from Robinson. And again. And it's a turnover.
Good defensive play. The assistant coach that we see consistently standing next to Bobby Knight is Ron Fellen. He won four state championships in Illinois, an outstanding high school coach who's certainly ready to be a major college head coach.
Keith Smart just prior to the buzzer. And Indiana at home finishes with a flurry in the opening half.
That's the explosive one-on-one ability of Smart. That's something they were lacking in the past, the ultra-quickness of Keith Smart.
The general is walking, and you have to figure they'll play the second half in this game. They're up by five. Let's get back to John Saunders in the studio.
Certainly Bob Knight against his good friend Digger Phelps is not about to take his team off the floor, at least except for halftime. 38-33 is the score. The Hoosiers have the lead. Let us go around the nation as we continue on the Hartford halftime report and check some of the other scores. First of all, from the top 20, Kentucky, which moved up to the number two team in the nation at the Wildcats. They have a 36-27 lead over Cincinnati. That is still in the first half. Number six, Iowa. The Hawkeyes in this one have a lead as well. 36-27, that also over Drake, and that in the first half. Pomona Pitzer facing Kansas. The Jayhawks now the 16th ranked team in the nation. It is a three-point lead in the first half. Kansas leads it 12-9. Bridgeport and Seton Hall. Seton Hall coming off a good performance in the Big Apple NIT. They have a 10-point lead over Bridgeport. That still in the first half as well. Jackson State and Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech, a team that has dropped out of the top 20, have a 7-point lead at the half over Jackson State, 39-32. Bobby Kremen's squad with the lead. Niagara and DePaul, the Blue Demons. It's an early game, and they have a 2-point lead over Niagara in the first half. It is 8-6 very early on. And Western Michigan, the Broncos facing Ohio State, and the Broncos are having a hurting put on them by the Ohio State Buckeyes. It's 78-57 is the score. We will continue with more of the Hartford Halftime Report in just a moment, so stay with us. When we come back, we'll take a look at the state of basketball in Indiana. And the Indiana Hoosiers have a lead over the Notre Dame Fighting Irish, 38-33.
Trophy whitetail deer hunters are a dedicated lot, but the bow hunter is a very special breed. Hi, I'm Kurt Gowdy, and now for just $49.95, you can experience bow hunting in its purest form in our new videotape, The Bow Hunter. No greater challenge is presented to a bow hunter than bagging that elusive whitetail trophy. Now you can live it almost firsthand and revel in the victory of the prize. Whether your approach is high-tech or basic and simple, you'll thrill at the hunts in this video. It's the next best thing to being out in the woods yourself. I know you'll want to order yours today.
Use MasterCard or Visa and call 1-800-554-9000. That's 1-800-554-9000. Or send a check or money order to The Bow Hunter, P.O. Box 121, Plainville, Connecticut, 06062. Order The Bow Hunter today.
Today you need an insurance company with a firm financial footing, a company with staying power and intelligence to see you through year after year, a company with experience you can count on. You need The Hartford, the insurance people of ITT. When you need us most, we're at our best. That's The Hartford difference.
Millions of miles and millions of cars, more of them every year. They're riding on Kendall Motor Oil. That's
Every year, people like racing champion Big Daddy Don Garlitz rely on the protection and quality of Kendall Motor Oil.
Don Garlitz and Kendall Motor Oil, year after year.
Kendall, protection worth its weight in gold for more than 100 years.
This halftime report is brought to you by The Hartford, the insurance people of ITT. When you need us most, we're at our best.
The Hoosiers lead the Irish by 5 at the half. You know, there are many great concentrations of basketball in many states around the country. North Carolina and California come to mind. But in Indiana, basketball is king. That was underlined, that fact was, by the movie Hoosiers last year, a very big hit. In fact, when you look at Indiana, Purdue, and Notre Dame, you have the top three countries, certainly in a concentration of one state anywhere in the nation.
When you think of college basketball in Indiana, your mind immediately shifts to Bloomington, home of the Indiana University Hoosiers. IU has captured 5 national championships throughout its storied history, and last season's overachieving champions left a warm place in Coach Bobby Knight's heart.
What I think most of last year's team is that in games that were decided in the last 5 minutes of play, they made very, very few mistakes. And there were some games where with several minutes to play, 4, 5, 6 minutes, we were in a position where we could get knocked out of it. And they really didn't. I felt that they played as well as any team I'd been around in the last few minutes of games.
To help bolster his title defense, Knight dipped into Indiana's vast wealth of high school basketball talent by recruiting the Marion High backcourt of Jay Edwards and Lyndon Jones.
The fellas have been helping us a lot, and you know that's really helped us out.
But me and Jay, we always play good together, so
it's really been no adjustment by bringing our game down here together. It's just been, you know, trying to adjust to play with all the fellas.
Northwest of Bloomington, in the town of West Lafayette, sits Purdue University, a school with a pretty fair basketball reputation itself.
I know a lot of the people on other teams that we've played, and they really feel that this Purdue team is the type of team that really gets after you all the time for 40 minutes. And I think that's why we were pretty successful last year, because this team really wants to play hard for 40 minutes and not just one span or not just because we're behind.
Last season was one of mixed emotions for the Boilermakers. On the one hand, Purdue won 25 games and earned a share of the Big Ten title with Indiana. On the other hand, it was IU that captured the national championship.
It's just unusual, and it's hard for a Purdue team to root for Indiana team because we had such a great rivalry, but at the same time, I respect what Bob does over there, and he does a good job with his kids getting their degrees and playing hard, and we have a great, hard-fought, clean rivalry here, and we're going to keep it at least as long as I'm here as far as the way we play the game.
South Bend houses Notre Dame University, a school with a national reputation, which still thinks of itself as part of Indiana's basketball tradition. However, while Indiana and Purdue get a bulk of its recruits from in-state, the Fighting Irish usually look elsewhere. Notre Dame's spectacular senior guard, David Rivers, enjoyed coming to the state of Indiana after he was recruited out of Jersey City, New Jersey.
It's a basketball kind of state. The people really follow the game here, and they take it very serious. When I first came out here, I saw the high school games were publicized and things like that, and you don't get that kind of coverage back in the East. And you know, they really take it serious here.
Everyone knows who Notre Dame is. I mean, Indiana doesn't mean Notre Dame necessarily, but Notre Dame is Notre Dame. And I mean, people know Notre Dame is in Indiana, so however you want to translate that.
I think how we would like to translate it is that tonight, Notre Dame is in Bloomington to play Indiana. Both teams are from Indiana, and at this point, the Hoosiers have a 5-point lead at the half as we continue. 38-33 is your score. Indiana and Bobby Knight leading Digger Phelps and the Notre Dame Fighting Irish.
The event, the prestigious black and white ball, the place, the cultural heart of Northern California's wine country. And the wine served, why, Cribari, of course. Wines of tradition. In 1859, Isaac Cook created a great American champagne to launch the great American clipper ships. Today, people are still launching celebrations with Cook's Imperial American Champagne. Just in time, American Express introduces Purchase Protection. It insures almost any retail item you buy with the card for a full 90 days in case it's accidentally damaged, stolen, or simply flies away. You don't buy this protection. It comes automatically only with the American Express card. Membership has its privileges.
Central, vital signs are dropping.
It's an emergency. You're going to need blood. Blood you can trust. That's why DuPont worked to create a highly accurate method of testing to help protect our blood supply from the deadly AIDS virus. Their system enables us to have more confidence that the blood we need to live won't be hazardous to our health.
Your husband's gonna make it.
At DuPont, we make the things that make a difference. Better things for better living.
Dear Pop, I know how anxious you must be to get this letter, but I think you'll find it was worth the wait. As you can see, he's got your eyes, your smile, even your stubborn chin. So we thought he should also have your name. Say hello to Jonathan Jr. Merry Christmas, Pop. We're coming home.
Christmas and Kodak.
Thursday, college basketball action. The UCLA Bruins strong backcourt combination goes up against the powerful front line of the Temple Owls. Live Thursday night on ESPN.
38-33 is your score at halftime. The Indiana Hoosiers leading the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. The Irish certainly with some work cut out for them. However, David Rivers is having a tremendous game at this point. So let us go back to Bloomington and Assembly Hall to Dick Vitale and Tim Brent.
Welcome back to Assembly Hall in Bloomington, Indiana. Tim Brando along with Dick Vitale, and right now the Hoosiers with a 5-point lead. And coach, when you stop and analyze this game, it really is the outside of Notre Dame versus the inside of Indiana, at least to this point.
Well, Notre Dame's gotten great play out of David Rivers on a perimeter. He's done a tremendous job shooting the jump shot. He's really been a dynamite little player there, but they haven't been able to get him in the open court. Take a look at David right now in a one-on-one situation. He's going to shoot the jump shot from the perimeter, and he kept Notre Dame in the basketball game. On the other side, when you looked at Indiana, they really had excellent play from Dean Garrett on the interior. Here he is with a slam jam bam, and Dean's been a dominant player both defensively and offensively.
It has been an outstanding week in college basketball, and we're just underway. When you stop and think about the play both in Alaska and at Maui, there was also another tournament in New York that was held. A lot of great players this week.
Well, you talk about some great play this week. Certainly Sean Elliott was a star over in the Great Alaska Shootout. Jeff Moe had a tremendous tournament at the Maui Classic. But when you talk about the player of the week, I gotta go with my guy Norman Sloan's man, Vernon Maxwell. I thought Maxwell was superb. He played brilliantly against Seton Hall. He scored an average of 27 points a game, and he's my choice as the Windex Player of the Week.
And we'll have that for you throughout the course of the year here on ESPN. $1,000 from Windex will be donated to the club of the choice of the athlete involved in his hometown. Vernon has already made his selection. The Boys Club of Manchawa in his hometown of Buchholz, Florida, they have $1,000 in the name of Vernon Maxwell. At halftime, the Indiana Hoosiers lead the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame by 5.
Great view.
Great streak on your side.
Not my side. I'm using Windex with ammonia D. It doesn't streak.
Well, I'm using this.
No ammonia D.
Here's the streak.
See why I trust Windex?
When Windex is on your side, the streak isn't.
Splish splash, I was taking a bath. Long about a Saturday night. Glubbed up, got a clog in my tub. But Liquid Drano fixed it up right.
Liquid Drano, the liquid strong enough to be called Drano.
Today you need an insurance company that looks out for you year after year. A company with experience, measured in centuries instead of years. A company with a firm financial footing. You need the Hartford, the insurance people of ITT. When you need us most, we're at our best. That's the Hartford difference.
That's him, isn't it?
You bet it is.
He's good.
I just love the way he parties.
Do you know why Spuds McKenzie has so much fun at parties?
Because he's always in control.
And he knows how to make a party last. It takes good sense to have a good time. And Spuds knows it's cool to live by one simple rule. Know when to say when.
A reminder from Anheuser-Busch. If you ever thought you had to give up comfort to get a close shave, think again. Norelco puts close and comfortable right in the palm of your hand with a revolutionary system that shaves skin close in a way that's incredibly comfortable. With a patented lift and cut system that lifts each hair so it's possible to shave skin close without the blades even touching the skin. A shaver that defies logic gives you a shave that defies belief. Norelco Rotatract, where close and comfortable come face to face.
Fan members here at Indiana enjoying this game, as are the rest of the fans here in the state of Indiana. The Hoosiers right now with a 5-point lead. Let's look at the statistical data. First, from the floor, both clubs have been shooting well. Notre Dame tapered off at the end of the first half.
Well, Indiana, great shot selection. It's so typical of a Bobby Knight basketball team, and they shoot 52% from the floor. Notre Dame 40%, not getting anything on the inside. Everything is on the perimeter. And then you look at the 3-point field goals. Indiana shooting 3-for-4. Notre Dame 5-for-11. So the 5 gives them a 2-edge there, and it gives them 2 more points in that area over Indiana. Free throws, 4-for-6 for Notre Dame. Indiana 3-for-4. Most of the action is coming on the perimeter, Tim, but the edge on the inside, as we look at rebounds, are basically equal, 16-14. The edge has been that Indiana has been a little bit more dominant as we look at the turnovers are even on the lane inside. And there it is, Indiana with 16, Jadlow early with a couple of baskets, but Dean Garrett's been the difference on the baseline, on the interior.
And, of course, there's Olympic background here in the state of Indiana, what with Coach Knight's success in 1984. We showed you the 3-point shooting from the outside. Well, David Rivers, 4 of those 5 belong to him. He has 14 points. And you see the rest of the story. It has been all Rivers.
I just got done talking to Billy Knight and George McGinnis coming up here. Knight, who was an outstanding NBA player, and George McGinnis, a legend in the NBA. And I asked them, I said, hey, you guys know more than I know. Can David Rivers play in the NBA? And they said, Dick, without a doubt, he's quick, he can shoot it, and in the open court, he'll even be a better player than he is now in the collegiate game.
The Hoosiers have been more balanced, and you can tell that they're two stars, Smart and Garrett, particularly Keith in the last 5 minutes of the first half.
Well, thank you for the JUCOs. Hey, JUCO jammers, you see people are going that route right now across America as we look at the score. Hey, there's Tate's Lock, the legendary Tate's Lock. And you talk about loyalty, the reason he's on this staff. He gave Bobby Knight his first job as an assistant coach in college at West Point. And let me tell you something, if Bobby Knight is your friend, he will do anything for you. Tate's Lock was out of work. Tate's Lock was in a situation where he was involved in a very controversial book about recruiting violations at Clemson, and Bobby Knight had an opening, and he gave his friend a shot. Now we look at Digger Phelps and his staff, John Shumate and Matt Kilcullen.
And both coaches are responsible for sending a lot of assistants into head coaching jobs themselves. Digger Phelps has 10 that he's brought in to the business at the full-time level alone.
Well, Bobby Knight's got a who's who. You start with Mike Krzyzewski, certainly one of the rising stars in college coaching, getting ready to go to that next level to join all the Rolls Royces.
You saw one of them, Bob Donowald, whose Redbirds of Illinois State gave Purdue all they wanted last night. Gary Vos with the first rebound of the second half. The Irish down by 5.
You almost had a tip-in for a score by Callaway. One of the real problems with the matchup, you don't have a specific guy to block out, and therefore guys get openings and get a lane to hit the offensive boards.
Sean Connor's shot won't fall. And Vos and Callaway were both down low. Gary picked up the foul.
I believe Notre Dame's going to try to find a way to get the ball inside a little bit more than Vos in the paint. Vos scored a great deal at the end of the year in some key games, but they got to find a way to make that entry to the big horse down inside.
number two on Gary. And of course, they have to keep him in the lineup, although Robinson, who starts the second half for the Irish, can certainly score down low if need be. He's really the only change in the starting lineup for either team here in the second half. The alley-oop for Garrett.
Great timing right there. They throw it over the top of the defense. He sneaks behind the baseline trio, and they execute that to perfection.
Equaling the largest lead of the game, the Hoosiers up by seven with just over a minute gone in the second half. Keith Smart is now shading Rivers, and it nearly worked. They nearly forced the turnover.
What an athletic play by David Rivers. He made a tremendous play just to catch that ball.
Connor is open.
Connor can shoot it, Timmy. He's got good range. The one thing about both these clubs, a Digger Phelps team and a Bobby Knight team, boys, patience, and shot selection, and it usually equals W.
Callaway feeds Isle, and he's fouled by Vos, his third.
Very rarely do you see these teams take bad shots, and that's all really, in my relationship, that goes to the coaches. That really does. It's their plan, it's their game plan, their execution, and what they do in practice that dictates that shot selection.
Callaway to inbound. If you're looking for a player that perhaps had a disappointing first half, it would be Ricky Callaway for Indiana.
Yeah, he wasn't active like you remember. Going over the top again, not going to get away with it the second time.
Look at Isle keeping it alive. And then Rivers with his athleticism taking it away.
Athleticism? Don't use those kind of words. That's too big for me. You don't know how to talk about one-syllable words, will you, Brando?
You lost about three syllables in the time change, right? Stevenson. Greensmith picks it up for Indiana. Dick Vitale, six games in 5 days, all the way from Alaska to the heartland of America and the home of the national champion Indiana Hoosiers tonight.
And getting paid to sit here at courtside, I don't want to tell people, it's like stealing money. But Chris Smith, what a positive force he's been off the bench.
Callaway turned it over.
Two on one, he's got to make the play right. No. That's too Hollywood, around the back, should have dropped the bounce pass. Not a good play. Digger's certainly disappointed in the All-American there. Don't need it, David. You're too good a player. Here, a little showtime. He wants to go around the back. See, going around the back is one thing, but going around the back from the left side in that fashion is really difficult. If you were on the other side of the floor with the right hand, he can make that play.
Turnovers are even, or near even. David Rivers has committed three for the Fighting Irish and a foul on Connor. The penetration of both Cree Smith in this game since entering and Keith Smart has really helped the Indiana offense.
That's the key word, penetration. So many people think you have to beat the zone over the top. The key in attacking the zone is basically, number one, drive it into the gap with a seam in that zone, penetrate it, and then things will happen.
Smith out of Tipton, Indiana, played in 25 games a year ago, missed five contests with a torn thumb ligament, also had a knee injury.
He also, this year, jogging before the season even started, he had a stress fracture and was out quite a while, so this kid's had a lot of injuries in his career.
The iron unkind on both charity attempts, and the Irish could get back to within two or three with this possession.
Balance, they get good spreading. There's the screen, little screen and roll.
Robinson shuffled his feet.
We see that often. I saw that a great deal over in the Great Alaska Shootout. So many players just lift that pivot foot.
And the more talent you have, the more apt you are to commit that turnover.
Well, in the NBA, they'll let you get away with that sometimes. They'll let you slide that pivot foot.
Ellery, Kevin Ellery, one of the many great young players in the Digger Phelps system is in the game now for the Irish. Down low on aisle number 35 in blue. There he is picking up Callaway. And Ricky connects.
Ricky Callaway is going to have to score 15 to 16 points this year per game if Indiana has any chance again to get to the Final Four out of Kansas City. They need that kind of productivity out of his ability.
There's Ellery. Callaway picks him up, and he's fouled.
Digger told us that he has a great knack for drawing fouls, and you can see that right there. He thinks he's going to be a solid player. He thought he was a late bloomer at the end of the year in the high school tournaments. Take a look at the help right now. There's the ball. Now look at Indiana. They got four guys in the lane. Four guys in the lane. Now, he drew the contact, but the one message they sent is simply this. You will not drive the lane for an unmolested layup.
The foul prior to the shot attempt. So the Irish have it out of bounds.
I want to say thank you to the guys up there. That's a great shot.
Al again with great defense for the Generals team.
Gotta like this kid. You gotta like this kid. He may not be super quick, he may not jump high, but he is a winner with a capital W, Steve Isle, timeout digger.
Well, the general has a Secretary of Defense in the form of Steve Isle, the senior from Hamilton, Ohio, and they lead by nine.
To the wire in the Johnson Family Coliseum. It's VCR basketball. Johnson passes into the key and gets the VCR card. He hits the VCR, and the NBA pros hit an alley-oop for two. Randolph inbounds it, turns over a VCR card, and the NBA pros give him a slam-a-jamma. Johnson inbounds it, and he's called for charging.
Get the VCR basketball game and play at home with the NBA pros.
He hits it, and the Randolphs win VCR basketball.
Get the official VCR basketball, football, and hockey games at a store near you.
Think we're gonna make it?
If this thing does.
Well, at least we're playing back in a 747. Aren't we?
Northwest has an all 747 fleet to and from the Far East.
Yeah. Harry, Kalamazoo Tuesday? I can do that. Memphis Wednesday? I can do that. New York Thursday? I can do that. How am I going to do that?
No matter where you do business, Northwest can fly you there.
No, no, no. In a battle drill, you need horsepower, firepower, people power. That's teamwork.
Moving tank, track front, 2,000.
This team uses a computer, thermal sight, laser rangefinder.
Yeah.
All that you can.
We win, the whole tank wins. The whole team wins, not just one person.
Find your future in the Army.
Let's take a look at the Indiana team defense. We talk about pressure on a ball. Here goes Rivers. Freeze it right there. Notice how four guys are in the lane. They have great help defense at all times. They pop the ball loose, and here comes the finalizer in transition. Steve Isle's going to finish it off. He's going to finalize the play. Great hands. Look at the way he can pop that ball. He looked a little bit like you going to the goal, Mr. Brando.
Smallest hands in broadcasting I've got. Indiana, there you see from the floor, 50%. Notre Dame has been virtually cut off at the lane, haven't they?
Well, you know, they have to have so much poise right now. 16 minutes on the clock, a 9-point game. Notre Dame certainly in the basketball game. David Rivers so explosive as a scorer. What they have to do right now is come up with a big score. And if you need a big score, you got to get it out of your money guy right now. You got to get it at Mr. Rivers. Hey, I must have all these signs here because I want to tell you the truth. I snuck in from Alaska and I was out in the parking lot making them all up. And I paid a few kids to run around here with them.
People don't know these things. They need to find them out. I'm glad you mentioned all of that.
I'd like to be honest.
The Irish down by nine. And you know that this is the man that Digger Phelps wants to have the ball.
See, they're playing off him right here. They got to come up with a good screen for him. Trying to deny the ball to him. There's the screen. Look at Paddock trying to get that screen on him.
And a near steal and a foul on Keith Smart. That will be his second. You'll recall he had one waved off towards the end of the half when he had the in the cylinder violation.
Notre Dame's not going to face the kind of defense they're facing here on a regular basis. And when they get into a situation where people go up and down the floor, Rivers is going to put 30-35 on a board many a night this year. Last year, he wasn't at the full speed, full throttle like he is now. Smart, really meeting the channel, playing challenge, playing Rivers one-on-one.
Now the charge against David Rivers.
Great defensive play. What lateral quickness right there by Mr. Smart to pick up the offensive charge.
How many times do you see a player under Bob Knight after making a mistake and picking up the foul, making absolutely certain that he makes a big play shortly thereafter?
Well, you better make sure you do, or he'll get BT, bench time, sitting next to the general. Listen to him in one of his tirades. You think that earthquake was earth-shattering? Have him come after you verbally, baby.
Hoosiers looking for a double-digit lead on this possession.
Psychologically, that could really hurt if they get a score here.
Remember, Bo's playing with three fouls down low.
And remember, Notre Dame plays excellent defense as well. You look at their totals over the past few years. Last year allowed only 59.8 points a game.
Callaway!
Ricky Callaway, that's what they need out of him. He's a wing shooter, he's a driver from out of Withrow High School, Louis Orr School out of Cincinnati, Ohio.
He missed last year's game because of that medial collateral knee injury he had. The Irish, of course, lost that game by five, as we documented earlier. Rivers off the back iron, Keith Smart bringing it down, and Smartly holding on to it. The numbers were against him.
If he's in an ice situation, it really hurts. And when he gets cold, they really need his scoring.
Isle saving it to Callaway. Dylan Garrett to Keith Smart.
Oh, what a great play down the gut of the defense. They spot the opening, they spot the gap, they slide right through the gap. He's going to get a timeout. He's got to get a T.O., a timeout right now. Digger's got to get a timeout, settle him down.
David Rivers
scored. He's furious.
Rivers had 14 points in the first half. After 6 minutes in the second half, he's scoreless. Therein lies the reason Digger's down by 13.
Trophy whitetail deer hunters are a dedicated lot, but the bow hunter is a very special breed. Hi, I'm Kurt Gowdy, and now for just $49.95, you can experience bow hunting in its purest form in our new videotape, The Bow Hunter. No greater challenge is presented to a bow hunter than bagging that elusive whitetail trophy. Now you can live it almost firsthand and revel in the victory of the prize. Whether your approach is high-tech or basic and simple, you'll thrill at the hunts in this video. It's the next best thing to being out of the woods yourself. I know you'll want to order yours today.
Use MasterCard or Visa and call 1-800-554-9000. That's 1-800-554-9000. Or send a check or money order to The Bow Hunter, P.O. Box 121, Plainville, Connecticut, 06062. Order The Bow Hunter today.
Watch Garrett with the cut down the gut of the defense. There he slides in. He's going to slide up. Freeze it! See what happens right here. Number 40, Jameer Jackson has no vision, does not get down the lane and help position, and he recognizes that, does Mr. Smart, and he gets the easy layup off the good interior pass. Hey, there's my 17 years, my all-digger team at Notre Dame. Rivers, Brokaw, Shumate, Dantley, and Trapuka. Orlando Woolridge would be a candidate as well for Mr. Knight. He'll disagree with me. Isaiah, Alford, Benson, May, and Woodson. He'll say, where's Wilkerson? And of course, his favorite, Quinn Buckner. As much as I love Quinn Buckner, a great college player, I got to go with the little guy, Isaiah Thomas.
He would also tell you that the 76 team that went unbeaten was not his best team. He would say the team prior to that, the year before, was the best team he ever had. So,
well, he doesn't like to talk about that, but down deep, I know he really believes that. 75 was his premier team of all time.
Most rejected by Garrett. Another of his many blocked shots.
Garrett with a great shot blocking ability inside. That gives you a different dimension. It takes away any kind of inside basketball.
The Irish need a hoop here badly. Rivers will get it, count it, and it could be a three-point play.
They really look for all their offensive productivity out of David Rivers. David with a great pump fake inside. I'm a big, big David Rivers fan. Here he is now at a good crossover step. Look at that explosive move. Oh, he freezes the two defenders. Isle has just left something on the floor, as Mr. Garrett did. Same thing happened to Ronnie Cicely over in the Great Alaska Shootout. Those pump fakes, he was leaving his feet.
Irish now 2 of 7 from the floor in the second half, while the Hoosiers are 5 of 8, and it's a 10-point Indiana lead.
They come out and play man-to-man defense right now. Here's where they execute that great passing game. Screen and go away. They usually get excellent. See how he screens and goes away? Smith. They'll pass, they'll cut away or replace themselves or cut through. And they really screen on the interior.
Baseline, lost the handle. Callaway there to pick it up.
Well, Ricky really wants the ball, and so does Dean Garrett.
They're not getting enough movement offensively, and they're playing very stationary.
Smart baseline. Bose with the board.
I don't think they recognized the man-to-man defense in that series. They were very stationary, as though they were attacking a zone defense as opposed to a man-to-man.
Now it's Rivers at the off-guard spot against Smart, and Jameer Jackson running the show against Tre Smith. That one woefully short.
Well, it's short because, again, of the shot-changing ability of Garrett. Garrett rotated over. See, that's what Ronnie Cicely does for Syracuse. He doesn't have to score to be such a productive player. And Purvis Ellison, I really believe you're going to see an improved Louisville team this year. In fact, I think Denny Crum's going to have them really ready to play. They open up with Notre Dame.
That will be on Saturday. They've got that huge doubleheader over at the Hoosier Dome.
See, now they're playing the zone again. Now they're back in that matchup.
Smart inside the paint.
Well, he gets right into the gap of the matchup. He slides through again. No one recognizes him. Lack of communication. Digger's talking to him right now about matching up. They're not matching up, finding a man in their area of the floor.
14 points for the senior from Baton Rouge. He's Smart. Rivers gets the screen from Paddock off the front iron. Paddock has the rebound, and there's the fourth block shot of the game for Garrett. There's Keith Smart.
Little acrobatic move, and they're very enthusiastic. They're jumping with joy. It's jubilation time, dance time in Bloomington, Indiana. John Cougar Mellencamp must be here. What are your favorites?
I was born in a small town. They're making big noise in Bloomington. 52-40, the Hoosiers by 12, as quickly the Irish come back to counter. They have to watch closely, Coach. They could get blown out here. 11-17 left, and there's Isle.
Tremendous inside move right there. What an improved player. Last year he was a typical role player, and now he's really playing. Hey, when Joe Hillman comes back, Bobby Knight's got some decisions to make.
Nice inside pass, Paddock to Vos. Once again, Isle causing problems down low.
Good hustle by Vos to stay on top of it. We haven't seen the heralded freshman either, Lyndon Jones and Jay Edwards. Looks like they're going to have a tough time getting some PT this year, playing time. The Marion High School Supers.
Rivers, the three-pointers not falling in the second half for David. Paddock with another long rebound, and David tries again.
Well, that seems to be all their offense right now. One-on-one, David Rivers not getting anyone else involved offensively, and it's usually easier to defend one man than it is to defend the team. I think eventually Keith Robinson's going to be the guy on the front line to give a score.
Isle won't fall. Garrett keeping it alive. Paddock clears it to Mark Stevenson. Well, they'll need more of that from him.
He can score now. Mark Stevenson came out of Roman Catholic, played for an outstanding high school coach, Barry Brodzinski, now an assistant at Duquesne.
Smith is in trouble. There's the turnover.
Give it up.
Rivers over Callaway. Count it.
Good play, though, by Stevenson. The anticipation, the steal, and then the bounce pass to David Rivers.
Well, that was the first time you got the feeling that they were in trouble in their own backcourt.
They popped the ball loose. Now here comes the two-on-one situation. He drives the ball on a bounce pass. Notice how they're both wider than the lane. And I emphasized that last night, too, to young kids that are listening out there. In a two-on-one break, stay a little bit wider than the foul lane area and draw the defensive player to you and then drop off the bounce pass.
The youngster, Jay Edwards, one of two outstanding freshmen from Marion, Indiana, now in the game for Tre Smith.
You know, it looked like Indiana was totally dominating defensively, offensively, and we're looking at a seven-point game right now, Tim. So from Notre Dame's standpoint, they have not played exceptional basketball, and yet they're right in a ball game away from home. That tells me one thing. 20 games again will be won by the Fighting Irish.
They've cut the lead in half. In the last 2.5 minutes, they were down 13 moments ago. They trail now only by six. Just under 10 minutes left from Assembly Hall. Tim Brando and Dick Vitale with you. We're happy you joined us.
Is Notre Dame with a different look to their... Well, they're playing man-to-man right now. They're communicating on a matchup. You see Rivers release Callaway.
Oh, and there's Isle again. Steve Isle.
Hey, get ready. Eventually, he might be the Windex player of the week. What a performance here tonight by Mr. Ryle.
He played in all 36 games last year in a supporting role, literally almost every position outside of the pivot. Robinson over Ryle, fouled by Garrett.
Keith Robinson knows how to score. When he catches the ball, he's thinking score. He anticipates really well. The ball goes in the post. Now he wheels down the lane. Look at the help coming over. Look at Garrett rotating over to give some help to Isle. Here's the foul.
Isle picked up the foul rather than Garrett.
You know, Bobby Knight's philosophy is, number one, we must play to our potential. We do not play the opposition. We play against ourselves. And his second philosophy is that he doesn't want his team to be reactors. He wants them to anticipate. He feels when you react, you're on the defensive side. When you anticipate, you are taking a positive approach. I wish everybody out there could hear this guy lecture at a basketball clinic or camp. He is a genius when he starts to about the game of basketball.
He even lectured for us in the locker room, and he was not standing. He was taking it easy on the big couch.
Well, I had to drag you in here. You were a little intimidated, afraid. I had to say, come on, Timmy. And what did I yell at him? I said, you're not that tough. You got everybody scared. He said, find out, Dick. I'll show you how tough. I love coming around him. He's a piece of work, boy. But he's really beautiful on a coaching sideline.
It's a seven-point game.
Oh, they got him one-on-one inside now.
Garrett, baseline. There he is again, Steve Isle, nearly tipping it through.
They had a great passing angle into the box that time for Garrett.
Stevenson to a wide-open Rivers who lost Smart. The iron unkind, Bose keeping it alive. The youngster, Edwards, lost it out of bounds.
Okay, Edwards is going to find out if he's going to get some playing time coming in right now in a pressure situation. They'd like to see more emotion, more intensity out of Edwards. They think he plays a little too laid back. Played for a great high school coach, Bill Green. They won three consecutive state championships. Marion High School.
While Edwards was there, they were 85-4. That's pretty dominant.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. He'll have to play defense and play with intensity to get some playing time here in Indiana.
Vos bodies up and makes it happen.
Great power move by Vos. That's good power basketball. They made a heck of a run here.
Isle in the open court.
Nolan rotates over Robinson. See, he has to learn how to play on a defensive end. They came right down to gut. He did nothing to rotate over and to close the driving lane. But the youngster will learn. That's part of growing. The defensive process takes time.
Rivers
got a good shot.
Nice pass though. Stevenson taking the air ball and putting it through for the jam. 58-53. Edwards losing it. Out of bounds to Indiana. 7 minutes, 32 seconds left. Digger Phelps and the Fighting Irish feeling good. Down by five.
Holiday greetings from Budweiser. The people who bring you Budweiser wish you and yours the very best of everything this holiday season. If you're looking for the only mid-size pickup in America, with the heart of a full-size and the spirit of a compact, with available new V6 fuel injection up front, room in back for a full sheet of plywood, and covered by the best truck warranty in the business, it's gotta be the midsize Dodge Dakota.
It's gotta be a Dodge. Oh, yeah.
All right.
58-53. Digger Phelps giving out the info to his club that has clawed their way back down from 13 earlier. Don't forget, ESPN is your cable home for the NFL. It all begins with game day at 11:30 a.m. Eastern Time. Chris Berman, Tom Jackson, and Pete Axtell. They join you again for NFL primetime with the comprehensive highlights. And then the Bears and the Vikes. A pretty good battle in the black and blue division coming up Sunday night here on ESPN.
That's over at the Dome, and that means Anthony Carter, Showtime, and the Bears and Ditka go back to the Windy City with a big L.
Pretty impressive win for the Vikings on Thanksgiving Day against Dallas. And you see the Irish on quite a run, 13-4 in the last 4 minutes plus.
That was a great timeout by Digger Phelps when they were in trouble, and he's a motivator. And his team came out of the timeout. He could shoot the ball.
Edwards off the back iron, and Robinson with the rebound. You have to be impressed with Keith Robinson. He's really helped the Irish in this game.
Edwards' reputation is that he's a shooter. Lyndon Jones is that he's a point guard. Good ball reversal. They swing the ball.
Stevenson. I think someone got a hand on that one to obstruct it. Edwards caught in midair and still hits.
Little off balance shot, but he has a good touch. He's an offensive player. He's got all the typical shots in the repertoire. He's got the offensive arsenal.
He had 35 points in the Indiana State Championship game, and Lyndon Jones had 67 points. That's the other backcourt star in the semifinal game of the Indiana title.
He's going to get a test right now defensively. Look at him checking Rivers. Rivers says, hey, this is the big time. He made him take a bad shot.
Close, keeping it alive. Last touch by Notre Dame.
We're seeing a lot of strategy. These two guys can coach on that sideline. There you take a look at the Naismith recipient as coach of the year, the Basketball Weekly coach of the year, Digger Phelps. They don't win the number of games they've won over the years and not know the game of basketball.
They both came to these respective institutions in the same year. Phelps from Fordham and Knight from West Point.
Phelps had the New York area rocking and rolling.
Callaway off the back iron. Sean Connor with the rebound.
I think this possession is big right here, Tim. If you're looking at a big possession, they got to get down to the five or maybe four, maybe come up with a big three-point block.
Under 6 minutes left.
They got to go to Vos. There they go down to the horse.
Inside.
Yes, the big fella gets the three-point play.
Oh, Garrett is frustrated as well, and so is his coach.
Well, he knows it's a war now. Now it's going down the wire. What looked like a game that was ready to be put away, the knockout punch was not delivered, and Notre Dame's back in. Watch the horse inside. He's going to sit down in a box. He takes it up at Garrett, scores, and gets fouled. He says, yes, it's good.
Garrett had the outstanding first half. In the second half, it's been when Isle has played well in stretches that the Hoosiers have really taken control of the game.
Edwards still doesn't play with a lot of confidence on a floor. You can see him, he hesitates. I know he made that off-balance shot. He's getting some pressure time right now.
Well, essentially, both coaches have done that with their youthful talent that has recently been recruited. We saw Phelps do it in the first half.
Notre Dame plays that man-to-man. They disguise it. It looks like a zone. They do a great job giving help. They communicate. It's almost like a matchup. They're playing man right now.
Foul away from the ball. Vos and Stevenson in the general area. It may have been Mark Stevenson that picked up the foul.
The one great asset that you must have as a coach on the sideline in the modern era is controlled tempo. We hear that term tempo, the timing of a game. For example, Arizona took the tempo right away from Michigan with all their great athletes. Bill Feeder's team was reduced to a half-court game, and it was a blowout. You see right here, you're not seeing many fast break opportunities, Tim. These guys can control the tempo of the game. They're masters at it.
Edwards with the rainbow.
I gave you my scouting report. Reputation, Mr. Edwards can shoot the ball.
Many of you may have seen him at the U.S. Olympic Festival in North Carolina this year. He played with the gold medal winning South team. He teamed up with J.R. Reed. Robinson shot off the back iron, and Garrett with the rebound.
That was a good looking move by Keith Robinson. He drilled to the goal, came up empty, but he shot it. He had quickness inside. He's going to be an outstanding player with the Fighting Irish.
Edwards for shooting.
He can shoot it. Edwards the star here in the last few minutes. He's looking over Coach Knight. He says, get me some playing time, Coach. I'll put some numbers on the board.
David Rivers comes back and won't fall. Irish keeping it alive, and there's a foul. Edwards both were there. And the foul against Steve Isle is third.
I don't know if it's just that he's cool, calm. He shows no emotion at all when you watch Edwards play. And he told us that in the locker room before the game, Bobby Knight. He said, I'd like to see him a little bit more intense.
Ricky Callaway picked up the foul rather than Isle. Both of them had arms waving. They really could have logged the foul against either.
We saw Danny Dockage on the sideline. He was the guy that got all the headlines the year they upset. I mean upset North Carolina with Michael Jordan for stymieing Mr. Jordan. I thought it was Dean Smith taking him out of the game and letting him sit for a long period of time after he picked up two fouls.
That may, you mentioned Edwards, and so did Coach Knight prior to the start of the game, but a guy that makes it look easy, you figure going in with Coach Knight's personality, is not going to be one of his favorites early, right?
Well, I'll tell you, are you saying his personality is a little unique?
No, he wants, he likes to see the guys with intensity. He'd rather see the guys that really get the most out of what they have and show that intensity.
Right, he likes players like Isle. He loves kids like that who are overachievers. But you better have some of those thoroughbreds, too, to flat-out play.
Yep.
And they had a crew here when they won the championship in 76. See, right now, Garrett's got to find himself to come up with a big play.
Isle, he's been there for some in the second half.
He made every big play. Any time that they were on the brink of being put away, to use the terminology of John Feinstein in his book, they basically have gotten big play after big play out of Steve Isle.
Coach Knight and his Hoosiers have scored six unanswered, and they're on their feet here.
If you're looking for the only compact car in the world that gives you fuel-injected turbo power, road-ripping front-wheel drive, 60 standard features, plus an unbeatable 770 protection plan, then look no further. It's gotta be the 1988 Dodge Shadow ES.
It's gotta be a Dodge.
Makita, the cordless power tool system more professionals use to work around the house or even build one. Makita, it's all the power you need.
College basketball stars in the state of Indiana have to come from a small town. Lyndon Jones and Jay Edwards did, and they led Marion to three consecutive state championships. Here they are in Indiana, and you can tell that Jay Edwards and Lyndon Jones are earmarked for success, Coach.
Well, there's a little off-balance jump shot by Edwards. Certainly he's got the great touch, good baseline move, and he's getting positive minutes. He's getting minutes in a crucial game and getting the minutes at a crucial period of time. I was kind of surprised Bobby Knight went to him, but he went to him and he's delivered seven big markers.
In the Miami of Ohio game, it was Jones that came on the scene first, considered the better ball handler of the two, but both can score very well.
That's going to be frustrating for him sitting there. He knows he's a great talent. He's looking on the floor and he said, I want my time. I just want a chance to play.
There's a steal.
Uh-oh. Credit that goal. You know who you credit that goal to? Jay Edwards for running a defensive move to free Mr. Smart. I'll tell you, he was running interference up the court.
Well, you wonder now if that's a backbreaker. It's now a 12-point game. The Irish had clawed to within four. Eight straight points now, unanswered by Indiana. Three and a half left. That's a four-point play, in essence, because you figure Notre Dame looking for the deuce off the inbounds play, and now an ill-advised shot by Robinson.
Well, if you were charting these teams with an OER, the offensive efficiency rating, I guarantee you that Indiana would chart kind of high. They really come down with each possession and get basically a good shot.
Now the Hoosiers will use some of the shot clock. It's down to 22.
The Big Ten is going to be one heck of a war. I'll tell you one thing. People may think Purdue struggled yesterday, but going over to beat Illinois State on the road is not a bad, bad win, believe me.
Bob Donawald has a fine team in the Missouri Valley.
Edwards. can't allow him to shoot the rock, baby. Jay Edwards, you're going to get some PT. He can score, and there's no substitute in a game of basketball for someone who can score.
Post on the blocks. Garrett got a hand on it. Holloway rips down the rebound.
This game is academic, Mr. Brando. It's another W for the General.
I'd say the steal off the inbounds was the back break.
Well, I told him in the locker room he definitely was wrong with his behavior. You heard me tell him. Taking that team off the floor against the Soviet Union, he said, I didn't take them off the floor. The officials signed the book and forfeited the game. But as I said earlier, it was his responsibility to leave the arena once he had the third foul.
And they're milking the clock again with this possession.
I love coming to watch this team play. They're so well drilled, and if you love the game of basketball, they play the game the way it's supposed to be played, defensively, offensively.
David Rivers rejected by Edwards.
Look at Edwards with the defensive play. Now he wants the ball. They should have kicked it right back to Edwards. He was wide open. I don't think Notre Dame's not going to be a good team. Digger's too good a coach. They got too much talent. And they got a lot of good young players. You watch Notre Dame. They're going to progress. They got a tough week with this game in Louisville. But after that, you're going to see this team win a lot of basketball games.
We've seen moments of brilliance from the stars of both of these teams.
They're spreading the court now.
There's a youngster that's been really brilliant.
And he can score. He can flat out score. Forget about emotion and everything else. The bottom line is he's tickling the twine.
Now suddenly it's a blowout.
Bobby's going to spring in his bench. There goes a slam jam bomber. Explanation point. Good night. Hello. Party time. Bloomington, Indiana. Oh, Bill Frieda, Gene Katie. Lou Henson, Tommy Davis, they're going to love to bring it down here to Indiana.
17-point game, the Hoosiers with the lead, and remember, just 4.5 minutes ago, the Irish were down by just 4. The defending champions in college basketball get off to a roaring start at home at Assembly Hall. The youngster Edwards may be on his way to becoming the same kind of talent that has brought Bobby Knight 3 national championships in his 16 years.
Well, he gives him the offensive productivity. Comes off the bench and he scores big. But don't forget, if you're a Notre Dame fan, you're going to have an outstanding year as well. This is a tough place to play your opener. I really believe Digger Phelps and both Bobby Knight are going to have just an absolute blue chip year.
The Indiana Hoosiers win by 17. For Dick Vitale, Tim Brando saying so long from Assembly Hall. Let's get back now to our studios and John Saunders.
Okay, thank you very much, gentlemen. Bobby Knight has lost some off his Indiana Hoosier championship team, most notably Steve Alford. However, you'd never know it tonight as they come out and blow away Notre Dame in this one. 76-59 is the final. We want to tell you we have more college basketball coming your way this week. 10 o'clock tomorrow, Temple faces UCLA as the Atlantic 10 goes against the Pac-10 Temple. The Owls, the 12th-ranked team in the nation. Then we have a doubleheader coming your way next week. It starts on Tuesday at 7:30. Connecticut against Villanova, that one from the Big East. That will be followed up by West Virginia and UAB, Alabama, Birmingham, a team you saw here on ESPN earlier this week in the Great Alaska Shootout. That one starts at 9:30. Let us run down some scores from around the nation. The second-ranked team in the nation, the Kentucky Wildcats, have a lead and a very big lead over Cincinnati, 75-54. Kentucky, number 2 in the nation. They just moved up this week. Number 6 is Iowa, and the Hawkeyes lead Drake 59-42. This one in the second half, the big 17-point lead for the Hawkeyes. Pomona-Pitzer faces Kansas, the 16th-ranked Jayhawks, and the Jayhawks are not taking it lightly on them. 61-29, they have the lead this game in the second half. 18 is Oklahoma, the 18th-ranked Sooners, and they trail Penn State 23-21. It's early in the first half, but the Sooners trail it by 2. Back with more scores in just a moment. Stay with us here. Once again, the Indiana Hoosiers make short work of the Fighting Irish from Notre Dame, 76-59. We'll be back in just a moment.
Hi there. You looking for Mr. Wright?
Give this guy a light.
Wow.
And Bud Light here.
Whoa. Ask for Bud Light, the light beer with the first name and taste. Because everything else is just a light.
Thanks. Keep the chains.
If you're looking for the only sports car in the world that gives you the superior traction of front-wheel drive, a competition suspension, and an unbeatable 770 protection plan, then look no further. It's gotta be the intercooled turbocharged Dodge Daytona Shelby Z.
It's gotta be a Dodge!
Oh, for a warm and cozy castle, insulated safely from the cold of winter.
Cold cuts?
Oh, for InsulSafe 3 from CertainTeed. Pure white fiberglass insulation, thermally efficient, non-combustible.
Oh, warm.
For year-round comfort, help protect your home or castle. Insulate safely with InsulSafe 3. Call your insulation contractor now.
Metropolitan Life manages assets of over $100 billion. That's some big security blanket. Get Met. It pays.
High above the Loire Valley is a castle that has enchanted travelers since the Middle Ages. But now travelers of all ages can be enchanted at the Hotel de la Bretèche. But if you go there, remember, bring your nose for wine and your Visa card. Because you can't check out without a glass of Pouilly Fumé. And you can't check in with American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
It's television's best college football preview. On-site reports from major showdowns. Exclusive interviews with top coaches. Unbeatable predictions. Live Saturdays on ESPN.
The Indiana Hoosiers, a 76-59 winner over the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. And we continue here with our NCAA basketball on ESPN. Running down some more scores from across the nation. Bridgeport facing Seton Hall. Seton Hall out of the Big East and gets a big victory in this one. 104-83 is the final for the Pirates. Jackson State and Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech, the Yellow Jackets, have not looked impressive this year. 79-71, they get the 8-point victory over Jackson State. Niagara and DePaul, the Blue Demons, not ranked, and they trail by two in the second half. 44-42 is the score. The Blue Demons in some trouble. Western Michigan and Ohio State, no trouble for the Buckeyes as they get the easy victory over the Broncos, 94-79, and they get the 15-point final victory in this one. Boston College facing Harvard, and Boston College making easy work of Harvard, 121-81, a 40-point romp as they go on to the easy win. Columbia and Manhattan wins it. This is now a final, 84-80. Manhattan pulls it out by just four. Southampton and Marist, this also a final, 76-49 is the final. Marist beats Southampton in easy fashion. As we continue, Rhode Island faced New Hampshire, and Rhode Island gets the win. 96-67 is that final. Randolph-Macon facing Old Dominion. This one is just completed as well, and Old Dominion gets the win. 74-62 over...